Hello everybody. Halfway through the week. Hope everybody's having a great time. So I've been on a massive clean up here. Well, call it a clean up, but sorting out loads of stuff. All the drawers had to be pulled out and organized, so made lots of progress, and I found some really cool odd pieces, which made me start look up stuff that I didn't know I bought. So apparently I've got a lot of these guys, the Exoforce mechs, a really cool minifigure with kind of a rubbery hairpiece. And there seems to be a limited edition one as well. The golden edition. Get that thing off the screen. That's... Will it disappear from the screen? Will it disappear? There it goes. Okay, cool. So yeah, set number 7714. The Golden Guardian. The other one I got was 8113. We got some really cool stuff coming up. All the sets, I took some sets back from, I took a set back from my kids, sounds bad, but they were cleaning out their room and they're not cool enough for Lego anymore, so. Phoenix, welcome in. Oh my god. Everything okay? Cameron friend is on. Yes. Welcome in. How's your week going? So this is the first piece that I found in amongst all the other pieces, which I thought was a really one of those kind of coral or pearl color to it. And extreme danger written on it, so it immediately caught my eye. And then I was looking up Bricklink and Brickset for this piece, and then found this really cool mech. Pretty good. You? Yeah, doing well. Work getting in the way of Lego, and I've been up sorting till all hours, almost 2 weeks solid now. But finally get back into building. I've found the pieces for this as well. This is a little Scarab Beetle set from the Adventurers. A really cool printed brick. I've got all these cool sets found in Philly. Welcome in. Got all these cool little sets on the list. And that's the Assault Tiger, and this one is the Golden War. That's 7714 is the one we're building right now. At the bottom, yeah, Bricks Mental jumped in and helped me with something with the new config file. When you update, gets changed, so need to update that, and it was done. So shout out to Bricks Mental again. Wonderful human being. Yeah, so some really really cool parts of this. You got the Technic panel wing. I haven't seen it in this color before. Kind of a coral gold pan color. And there should be, yeah, really cool minifig with really cool hairpiece. I like that Japanese manga. It's kind of a soft rubber. Really cool faces from, I think, the end of the noughties, I think, these came out. And they all kind of have that distinctive art to the headpiece. I'll just do a quick sort, nothing too fancy. How long did it take to build it on? I think there's that many parts to it. Hopefully we can get to 2 mechs built today, and then gotta spend some more time getting all the bricks together. Guess that's a bit of a pain. Because some of them are stickered like this, and some of them have lost their stickers. But then I'm looking for a piece that instead of looking for the piece with the sticker, I should be looking for a plain piece. And if I come across the one with the actual sticker, then bonus. We've got the rubber kind of punch cannon thing. With the trigger at the bottom. Some reddish brown pieces. Hopefully they don't break on me. That era that these were pretty brittle. But he speaks Japanese. Know what that means? What are you guys working on these days? Any cool bills? Mocks? Pets? Buy anything in the LEGO VIP weekend? The small Christmas X-Wing. Try to send a link there, Chili. Why don't you try to send their chili, but got held up by the automod. For me, a link if it was a link to something, I can take a look then. This is the original. Is it kind of like a Santa version? Oh, look, it's Santa Yoda. Nice. Cool. I've never seen that before. Is it like a limited edition version of something that was already expensive, making it even more expensive? Local shop sells it for 800 euros. My god. And I think your option is indeed a more sensible one. Although I've been looking at a set, pretty rare, in Blacktron. Haven't seen it for sale, seen it come up for sale in or 10 months online. That's suddenly come up for sale and it's kind of ridiculous, but I tell myself no, there's no way I'm paying that amount of money, and then 2 hours later I'm looking at the posting on the marketplace. On Bricklink it starts at 300. Huh. Nothing really then in unique to it then, or? This. Fortunately, I don't have the instructions. I don't think the scan is great quality either, no. And of course, the first page would be sideways. I twist this around. That's only the one page, shouldn't be too bad. I'm gonna hope that that's black and not dark gray. Oh wait, complete, it would be 600. Might as well just go for the extra 200 and make it the original then. Crazy prices. And I put the... I found the remnants of Poe Dameron's X-Wing from... scan quality, yeah. Yeah, it's terrible. Yeah, that's why I'd prefer anything before 2010. I usually want to hang on to the instructions in case you get something like this. They're fairly big pieces, so hopefully they don't, and they're fairly distinctive colors after the grays and the blacks, which doesn't seem to be too much, so. Yeah, I also found Poe Dameron's X-Wing. This one. And you got the switch for the wings. Later on, I found Mr. Dameron himself. And we got this little awesome dude. BB-8 just chilling out in the back. Hey, Blocksmith.
Forge.
Welcome in. Dude, I love that X-Wing. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Been abandoned by my children. So it's a... instead of a rescue cat, I got a rescue... rescue X-Wing. I like the mechanism for it to snap shut as well. Pretty cool. So yeah, wasn't doing much streaming, but it was fairly busy on the Lego front. I sourced the missing pieces from the Blacktron set, the Alienator. Now we got it fully complete. I even put in my old, I had a spare one of the covers with the Blacktron logo on it, so I just threw it in there. I love the walking mechanism. Yeah, a lot of little cool things. Little Scarab Beetle one. That was very cool. So I was looking for all these pieces and then I'd find other pieces and it just rabbit holes and spirals out of control, so I was like looking for five different sets at one stage and getting nowhere. So a lot of fun, but this one's really cool because I had no idea that I had this in amongst all the other sets. So like I used to buy big plastic tubs secondhand off people and just sort them out and clean them up. I did the Then I found this guy here, kind of an odd color or an odd piece to have, so started looking sets up and turns out I have a lot of the Exo-Force sets from the end of the 2000s, 2007 I think, 2005 to 2010. And it's something I've never really built before as well, so see how we get on. How's your day been, Forge? Let's see, what time would it be? Still midday for you, I think. Luckily, we're off that page. Really improve, though. Zoom doesn't work. Great. I think I'd only be zooming into poor quality, so maybe we're better off. We got different kind of sockets and holders. In these with the Optimus Prime build. Other side, we got the ball and socket kind of holder. Oh man, pretty good. Got off work early for the holiday. Nice. I'm not going back to work until next Friday, so. But what I'm reading there, Forge, is 14-hour stream. They bought 4 Lego advent calendars. They were 50% off. Nice. That's a really good deal. And you only bought 4? Yeah, nice one, Forge. No 14-hour stream. I did not buy the Friends one. Which ones are they? Like the Star Wars, Harry Potter, and then the normal Lego one? I got a friend from Ireland coming to visit. Cool. That's strange. It looks like you're the second person who's got someone from Ireland visiting. My neighbor's got someone visiting from Ireland as well. Star Wars, City, Potter, and Guardians. Okay, cool. Is that like a Black Friday deal, Chili, or an early Black Friday deal? Friends one has the reindeer. Ooh. Music is a bit dark. Let's see what we got. Put some classics. Really looking forward to it. Yeah, Black Week, apparently. I got the money and cashback card for next time I shop there. Nice. March shopping.
Breaking them.
many colors.
I have the small reindeer set from this already. Are you going for the full complement of reindeers for a Santa set? The friend's calendar wasn't appealing anymore. It's the most special parts I already have. Yeah. You get that Frozen set from Bixman. Oh, that was awesome. But 90% of that stream was just trying to convince Chili to buy it.
Can the law.
Well, unfortunately, went out of stock. Oh, you actually had a look? It was a good price, though. I've seen on local stream that the Walmart have the space set for $50. Suddenly have. Not living in the USA. Jealousy. I have a little printed tile with a code on it. Apparently we can go to exoforce.com with it. We can look that up later. I hope that it does not come back into stock. Let's see, this is our windscreen. We're working on the torso here. Apparently in there we got a grill plate, but oh, we do. Okay, we're on a double build here. Yeah, I didn't bother with any purchases myself. Not really the offers that I was looking for on the right set, so I didn't bother. I'll wait till the new year. See what's on offer then. Bit of dust under here. We got him. Let's see. Double check. I think these should be the ones that are stickered. There's nothing else that I don't show you. That's pretty cool. They don't even tell you to put the sticker on. Just magically appears in instruction number 9. Instructions are hard to make. I mean, I can imagine, right? Because I'd say you got the set designers and they just hand their design over to whoever. I mean, I'd love to see a documentary on this, or like, you know, like a little fly in the wall from like a start to finish for designing and getting a set out to production. I'd just love to. There's so many things to consider, like the order that you build things, how clear it is. These sets would be, I'd say, fairly simple enough, but like things like Technic just blow my mind how they get that all sorted out. Super interesting. Well, probably just to geeks like us, I suppose, but I have to do tours of their facilities. That would be on that like white Unrise. We got a black pin at the back. That leg thing, the ankle bone, let's say, in a swivel. Rex wing. I've been working on instructions for the Rex wing. Rex wing, Rex wing. What's the Rex wing? It's an unreleased model from Lego Movie 2. Oh. Rex wing. Any info online about it? Or is it only whispered in dark corridors? Who returns me an image of a T-Rex that has wings instead of arms? The Lego Rex. Any of these ones, we're into the T-Rex search results. Oh, render the mock I've been building in studio for a couple of weeks. Are you using studio, Blocksmith? Cool. I've seen Blitz was making a start on using studio during the week as well. I love this. I like this line here with the top canopy and the that kind of office window. Nice colors too. Hey, Maiku. Welcome in. I seen Maiku on a stream last night. Really cool. Whole front is transparent. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Is that a cockpit on the top part or? Why didn't I see this in my Insta? This is what I hate about Instagram. Hellbent. When did you post this, Blocksmith? Yeah, that's pretty cool. Posted a long time ago. Yeah, so I just got a video of some granny throwing 3 shots in a basketball instead of the actual stuff that I want to see. That's pretty cool. Are you going to source the parts and buy it? A raptor fits inside the pilot. Nice. Eruptor. Hang on. Be this guy. Dark blue pieces be tricky to get. I already sourced the parts and built it on stream about 6 months ago. Just got around to making instructions. Oh, cool. That was before my time. See if I can... I just started uploading my all my VODs into YouTube, so I can keep them saved. That's pretty cool, Force. Thanks. Yes, that would fit it, but one of the blue Rex Raptors is more fitting. Gotta keep it color coded, right? Not too bad. Bricklink about everything. All right, moving up into the shin bone. Alright, trying to pretty up these legs. Kind of looking like he skipped leg day. For now. The model is basically part for part what's in the movie. Nice, man. So what, did you just like freeze the frame and keep looking at it until it, until you got it? I did exactly that and also looked at the model in the video game. Okay, cool. But Jesus, look at this part. What the fuck is that? Oh, that's one of these things. Okay. So the felt cloth is pretty cool for everything except this color. It kind of disappears then. Now you can still see it on the site, on the screen. Okay, cool. Or... That's got to be a cool challenge to try and build something from side. Like, how do you figure out the kind of the internals of it then? Or what kind of frame to build it on? It took weeks. I can imagine. Get in there. These red pins are just fingertip killers. The internals I mostly figured out from the video game model. It all made sense though. Cool. I cannot believe it when the Raptor actually fit. Yeah, some talents can't be taught, Forge. Yeah. Legs looking a bit beefier now. It's going to be pretty big. Yeah, I'm surprised how big it is as well. We got the... going to meet up here. What's that about? Foot high, I think. Wish they would revisit that team now when they come back, make them so much better now. Yeah, exactly. A shout out to Maiku indeed. Thanks, Locksmith. Yeah, and you see kind of the how popular like the Gundam stuff is as well. They could tap into that market. Okay. Where do they want that to go? Above the kneecap. Yeah, who knows, Maiku? Maybe they had planned kind of a Bionicle anniversary tribute, right? So maybe I think the this should be up for an anniversary soon. I don't know when to start this line. I'll try my hand at designing heavy arms Kai from Gundam Wing Endless Walls. Cool. And do you have like a spare parts or you just break up an existing set? Be fire. Amor Sandrock would be the only ones that would be viable without a stand, as the wings and such, the others would make them off balance. Yeah. Oh boy. Bit of tubing here. It's pretty cool. Makes the foot look nice and beefy. Sounds crispy bills. Michael, I've seen that bus you designed for was it the Magic School Bus or something? Pretty awesome how quickly you knocked that one out. Sweet. We get to link up the torso. Horror stance. We got this kind of, get the name of this color, I think it's coral golden color. Early gold, is that it? Yeah. Yeah, so you can see it. Kind of colorations on the either. It's not just the one color through, it's got a kind of a haze on it or something. Pearl gold. Okay, cool. Oh, so I gotta build four of these. Yeah, so never built a mech before, so this is the first for the channel. This on it, and then the rounded piece. Ooh. Mech is almost getting into its first fight with me already. What else do we need here? This one. Four of these builds. And these are slotting onto the side. Ooh, that is nice. Now we cannot accuse this mech of skipping leg day. Nice and stands nice and sturdy as well. What the fuck is this? Yeah, I think the instructions aren't. You can see it here in the background, it's a bit. It's a bit off. Instructions for ants. I need. Locksmith, I need your enhancement goggles here for this one. Kind of guess this one. Quiet. Stickered ones. I can't see. Enhance, yeah, exactly. I'm gonna guess that that's the white one on there. Black. I don't have. Got another thing coming. See if we can find other instructions for this, because I can't make out what that piece is here at step number 3. Usually when you see these things sourced, they're all the same scan. 7. Yeah, this is better. And 2 pieces for that. Is there inbone parts? A golden Chinese symbol on there. Another one with Japanese writing. No idea what this is. Going on the front. Now, leg day has well and truly not been skipped. Build. This other piece in there. Ball joint. Click with a click. Nice. Those trans red parts are nice. This color. Is that like the reddish brown or brownish red or? Solid. Yeah. A sticker doctor in the house. Get you over here, obviously wasn't paying attention when Forge was given sticker class. That's our... satisfying click. Cool that the two arms have different functions. I don't fuck around when it comes to stickers. Indeed, you do not. I'll just put you to the back here beside Mr. Raptor. Maybe I should just get the keyboard out of the way for a bit. We got two. What's this guy? Hard to see a lot in the bionicle parts. So, Griso, did you get any sleep last night? I was up till about 6 a.m. having great fun in Prophet's stream. You were in streams till I went to bed here in North America, yeah. Yeah, just sometimes I have a good night's sleep and sometimes I don't, and that was one of them. But there's worse ways to spend a night. Their streams are always hilarious and good fun. So I kind of started my stream a bit early today. Hopefully I can get to bed at a normal hour. All day meetings tomorrow, so. I need to be a bit sharper than I was today. This sits on top of our torso. Back into the picture. There. You know if we can do anything about that? That peel in the corner, Locksmith? I get like a hair dryer or something and re-stick it. I had a good sized crowd last night too. Yeah, I think I tapped out around 6 a.m. here. A couple hours sleep. Little jet rocket pieces. Phoenix, man, I wish work was over. I know that feeling. More mortar might help. Hope it ends for you. Robin Hood Bricks on YouTube has some sticker repair tutorials. Okay, cool. We'll set up. And then I found a light brick as well, but it had kind of the battery had leaked in it. I want to see if I can fix that as well. What's the set number? For the light brick? It was a light brick on its own. Part number should be there. Oh, for the mech. Sorry. This one is 7714. Quick aside, you see the light brick. Now it's damaged. I'm gonna clean that up. Fix it. Another missile here. Got our wing pieces. On the screen anymore? No. Joining up our other wing. Looks like you can get a new sticker sheet for $3 on BrickLink. Cool. That's not too bad. Probably need to clean to get like gunk off. Well, there's only a few stickers that are. One for the shins here, and that one on the shoulders parts as well. But yeah, I'll look into it. At this piece, I seen as an exhaust on other Technic sets, but I imagine this is going to be a barrel of a gun. Okay, now comes that part that made me find this thing in the first place. Putting the cannon on the other side looks like you know, sticker. Oh, we got that one. Right arm is where the business end of the thing. Nice. Begin. Be on there. It's got that kind of a side target sticker on there. Got that roof tile part that sits over the edge of it nicely. Sad child. I thought the levers might be used to Globe magazine. Kids used to be subscribed to that, and I think they stopped printing it a while ago. Boom. I'm wondering if there was a comic thing that went with it as well. So, all set. Projectile warning, yeah, it's awesome. But yeah, it's a really cool set. A lot bigger than I thought it would be. Really sturdy as well. Really pretty set. Nice and sturdy. A lot sturdier than I thought it would be. Even lean it back like that as well. Those are some beefy legs. Looks good. Yeah. Yeah, really when it started out, I thought he was going to be in a little bit of trouble. Laughed at by his mech friends, but he knuckled down. Hit the right things. Maybe we just need to ignore the back of it. And I might could have done with a, you know, kind of a spine plate or something, or just something at the back. The party's up the front with this guy. Cool. Good time, we got 20 to 11. Party in the front half. Yeah, all effort was put into the front of those guys, I remember that. Yeah, I wouldn't think it'd be too hard to mod the back of it with some white plating. You've even got the pins, the red pins of some room here, and we got the back of these bricks that you can attach stuff to. First time chat from Smash Gilby. Hello all, welcome in. Ash Gilby is now a Shredder. Thank you for the follow. We're building... Well, we have built the Guardian Limited Edition one from 2007, I think. Cool. So he's got the large cannon, the projectile that goes into the eye of the small children's. Shield, and it's got the Exo-Force minifig, which I think is one of the coolest minifigs. Now we shall build the buddy. So we're building now at 8113. We got the altogether angrier friend here. Like the hair pieces, they're pretty cool. How are you, Smash Gilby? How did you find us? Are you into Lego? Gotta get an outfit like that minifig. Indeed, and metal. There we go. We're in the right place, I think. Yes, I'm usually streaming with some metal. This is actually a quite milder version of the metal that I usually play. Into more extreme forms of metal. So naturally I landed here, indeed. Oh, we got a large portion of friends in the Lego Builders group that are also quite fond of metal. We got Locksmith's Forge in there. A big fan of Slayer. Let's just check in on the stickers for this one. We're looking good. I don't know, would it pass the scrutiny of master sticker placer blocksmith forge, but seemed to be in very good condition. This guy was obviously paying attention. Yeah, so we got a channel redeem in there somewhere for if you want to request a song, we can stick it on. Really cool part I've never seen before. Sticker in there is in good condition as well. Saving up my shreds. Good, good, good. Pretty different kind of set of bricks to this one than the previous. Locksmith is Slayer. Do you have a favorite? My favorite band would be Carcass, a grindcore band from the 90s, who I seen for the first time about a month ago. Very happy with that. Nice. And yourself, would be your favorite? Or do we get to see when you save up the shreds? You have many of those blue transparent plates. So Rammstein live 2 months ago, sort of binging them at the moment. Early Avenged Sevenfold stuff as well. Cool. I'm made of metal. Country clean. I'm alive. Right. Quick color sort. Rev died. I don't know much about them actually. Hold on. Can't say I listen to them that much. Kind of missed that whole, I don't know if you could call them a hardcore band. The hardcore? The original drummer. Okay. state these are in. That's kind of similar to the other one. Isn't very good. These are terrible. See if we can find the last ones we found were good. Phoenix Brixel Stitch. Have you played Lego Star Wars The Skywalker Saga? When it first came out, I played the ever living shit out of that game. Kind of the completionist in us kind of drove us crazy. When it first came out, we were playing it on the GameCube. I'll have to check. I have the GameCube there, but not the games. They're downstairs. Let drink die. This is like the new one. Which is like the new one? Just change the build picture as well in our stream. I can pretend to be kind of professional. Does that work? Yay! But the real life blade dude is here we go. Augmented reality for everybody. You're a vet, kiddo needs me. No worries. Do your thing, Smash. The Skywalker Saga is all 9 films. Alright. No, I played the first trilogy, so from the first right now. Confuses me. It's the ones the classics, let's say. The classic film. And they weren't making any sounds, it was just kind of mimed acting from the cutscenes from the Lego bricks. Midnight. Is quality any better? Nope. If Rebrickable can help us out. Oh yeah, you can combine two sets as well to make an even bigger mech. Looks pretty cool as well. So that'd be what's that 8113 and 8114. Like are like drug dealers, just give you one and then they know you'll come back for the other one. Looks like we're stuck with the shitty instructions, but we got the book here anyway, so not too bad. Augmented reality. Devastator-like modularity hype. Do you have any of these kind of sets, Forge? Or does anybody have in the chat have these? Kind of new to me. Apparently you're not supposed to build bricks in a field of grass. I don't know who would have these very luxury carpets in their house that a whole 2x4 brick can sink into. Okay, this is an interesting start to the build. So it's using these goes on to the outside. That's something I've seen before. An interesting one to get exactly the right angles you want to build it. I have one mech, Ultra Caddy. Oh yeah, I got the bricks for that last week, and I built it for my wife. A really cool set. It's something we can leave for your show and tell on Saturday at Forge. Yeah, even that Duplo brick thing is really cool. Give it tidied away somewhere there. That is hell. You got the three. What I love about it is you get the three. The three faces of Unikitty in various stages of rage. Down brick. Yeah, let's see, is that a red transparent wedge? Rage. Yeah, I'll do a channel redeem on Saturday for that. You can take a look at it. A really cool build technique. I've never seen that used before. Using the sides of the thing and with one of those 4-point gears. They're going to be asking us to sticker these? No. Mine's not built. You'll have to do the show and tell here, man. Okay. Just a second, I'll run and get it. It hurts to hold the spiky thing. And there we go. There is the Ultra Caddy. Got one kind of cute face. And then we got the kind of stepped on a Lego brick face there. Yeah, it's really pretty hefty too as well. Nice build, nice shape to it. I love the kind of armored whiskered things going on here. There's the unicorn horn as well. All points of it are armored and spiky. We'll put her next to a pet for our you can attach her to the set 708292. Yeah. She is pretty metal. She is a very metal kitty. Oh, you beat me to it. Okay, cool. Yeah, there's some really cool sets come out of that. I never really looked at, kind of overlooked all that whole, just Unikitty was, very popular in the house. That arse was. Goes on the back to supercharge the car. Thanks for showing Ultra Kitty. No worries. It was just when you mentioned it, I remembered. It was like things like that. It was just keeping me busy all week, and like I was finding bits and pieces of her scattered throughout the house. Building her, and I built this scarab beetle part. He's got like the hieroglyphics print on the brick. That was a really cool. I just found that one part, then looked it up, and luckily it was only in one set, so you know exactly what you got. I think it's a part of the Adventurers set. current. Stickered part, slightly off center, but enough for me. The eye sticker at the top as well. Sticker? Jesus. There's one for you, locksmith. I need a little sticker like that. That is like a, I think it's like a little mini mech. Cool. Definitely need the enhance for that. Yeah, that's a yeah. It's supposed to be a scarab beetle, so you got the see it in the. You see all like the hieroglyphics and stuff printed on there. Even got the scarab beetle on there. Yeah, an absolute rabbit hole of distractions trying to, pay attention and look and like I'd find that part, go, ooh, what's this? Cool. And then just rabbit hole into finding the parts for that and then reading up about the sets and stuff. Cool. Okay, we just got a little mini mech. Goes beside Unikitty. With the mech army we're building up there. Join the army. Two shoulder pieces, I think. Yeah, so I think these mech builds will be collected enough of them to just go crazy and build your own creations on it. Pretty cool. eyepieces. You have that bionicle stuff as well, Forge, right? I have only one bionicle, bought it to see what it was all about. Oh, okay. Yeah, we got a few bits and pieces in a tub. There was also a kind of a big kind of knights. I forget what they were, what the series was called. Like there's knights with heels like this one. Exo Knights, maybe? But, not your oldest set, indeed. You've discovered. Yeah, I think it was Exo Knights. Also, like, large figures. With big swords, and some of them light up even. Have one here. I'll show it on. We can show it later. Hero Forge. Yeah, something like that. They're kind of like about this. I don't know if he's seen the like the Star Wars large figures that they brought out, kind of like that kind of a theme. Find it here. If I got it somewhere on brick set. Just a second, guys. I gotta open the door. Sorry about that. Wife forgot her keys. Exo Knights are minifig builds. Yeah, I couldn't find it. Here. Now, I can pull out the box and show you in a bit. It also kind of like knights with moving arms, shields and swords and stuff. Pretty cool. This is going on the bottom. Two legs now. Two of these for the feet. I'd only seen these on the older Star Wars. That's they kind of held the TIE fighter wings in place. Sounds cool, man. You got a lot of classic parts that. Yeah, well, I've been. Had my dark period at the end. From the. About 99 to 2000 and. 6 or 7, I think. So. Apart from that. 6 or 7 years, then I've been. I was collecting Lego, so. And then I was buying up people's collection, like they'd advertise a huge tub of Lego unsorted, and that'd be the kind of thing I'd buy. Pretty cool, actually, just keeps you surprises like this that were in your collection. pull this one up here. His rage kitty, angry kitty expressions. Nice. Apocalypseburg Unikitty. You've got this one? I may have bought one of these. Nice. Yeah, that's really cool. Beer. Are you going for like the... collect all the sets from the movie, or... nice how it lines up with the side of the other brick. Honestly, just stuff I really like. Okay, cool. But you seem to really like the Lego movie stuff. It's really cool getting to see like those kind of sets, because I would never even consider those ones, like the party bus and the and that round spaceship from that we seen last Saturday. Kind of opens you up to stuff that you would have never considered buying before. That's why I really love to check it out. Yeah, it's really cool. Rick's mental is into different stuff than me as well. Really loves the Ninjago stuff and even the Disney Frozen castle, things like that that I'd never buy. It's great to get a close-up look at these things. That's fine. Click coming up. That is fine. Click number two. Better. Feet and leg already starting to take shape. X-Mental has been talking about setting up a check it out redeem. Yeah. I think everybody should. I think it should be required by, you know, just mandatory. If you're switching Lego, then you gotta have a check it out. I had a similar one. It was like pick a random minifig. I got a tub of mixed minifigs in here, and I just reach in and pull one out and see what we can find out about. It's a boost. Stickers. Right. Had to fast forward to the bickering part. Now what would help? Put it around the right way. Wave of mutilation. Okay, heating up with the torso. Mutilation. Locksmith Forge redeemed. Pick a random minifig for 700. This is a really cool one. We got this guy. From the same theme as the Scar Beetle one. Actually got two of these. A pair of tomb guards with the thing I really like this, the scarab shield. The helmet is a pretty awesome detail as well. Really cool detail, because some kind of a golden necklace print on them as well. I forget. Is that like a pharaoh helmet? Yeah, yeah. I have another one. It's a... The frustrating things about cleaning up, because I've got another head for this and a pharaoh helmet, but I can't find the rest of the minifig. But yeah, find those two guys is pretty cool. And then those swords, I forget the name of those type of swords. Not a katana, and it's not a... I don't know if there's a swordologist out there can tell us what kind of a... almost has a kind of a sickle look to it. Yeah, thanks for the redeem. Stickers we've already got done. That might be, I think they're actually, they might be, would it be the same set? So you got the Johnny Thunder, the Johnny Thunder set. I think they're from around that same theme. Oh yeah, cool. It's set number 7306, Pharaoh's Quest. Oh, there's where the picture is missing. So you got the other guard is the other side here. You got that really cool staff as well. I'm not sure what I've done with that one. But the, I think they're around from the same time as your, Johnny Thunder, adventurers kind of, theme. And there's another one with like a pharaoh's tomb, kind of pyramid one. And it's really, really expensive. I've never even seen it for sale, but, or knew it existed, but. Here comes your man. You building this twice? Okay. Put on the wrong one. L20 sticker for the shoulder part. In here. He knocked over Eddie. That's the outside. Part there. Okay, gotcha. And I haven't listened to this album in years. Over a few of these songs on drums. Basser and Gigantic. Any of the... Pile around the wrong way. I love these gun designs, they're really cool. That infamous part, not to step on, yeah. Is it that one? Yeah, with the crystal one on the... Oh man. I'm almost feeling it already when you said it. Just... Silent tear as it rolled down my face. I'm just like trying to keep from screaming was the worst part. Just like doing this like high pitched sound that probably dogs could hear. Rebuilding here. Okay, it's a whole disc. Some serious damage with this thing. One there. Got onboard satellite TV in this mech. Very handy. And that mech sits into the... Oh, that's pretty badass. It's on, like... little drone mech, I think. Beginning of Angel of Death, yeah. Dude even sit in there? Awesome. Love this little drone mech he's got attached to his arm. That's pretty cool. Didn't even notice that. Oh yeah. We have this as well. Found parts for this. I found this kind of engine and the four. Oh, actually I have it here. And the those four wooden outer wing tips. That's those. That's a part of the rabbit holing that was been done. Nothing scarier than a mech with a mini me. Yeah, so I really like that. So I think I have a few more of these sets, but I just need to probably take another 2 weeks to part them, find all the parts for them, but really, really, really enjoy that build. Something I've built before. Pretty cool looking sets, and like, look pretty neat on display, I think, as well. Nightmare to clean, but pretty cool sets. All right, quarter to midnight. Good time to bow out. I want to thank everybody for joining in. We'll just we'll read out to someone. See who's online. Local is on. Hey, dude. Yeah. My beardy's on, but he's playing Tomb Raider. Moore is on. We'll go to, over to Moore. All right, guys. Thanks for joining in. And hope this was entertaining. I really enjoyed the build. Something I haven't done before, so have another cool one planned for later on this week. And be a pretty enjoyable one. One of a kind of another rescue set from my kids. So we'll take a look at that. We'll jump over to more and hopefully see you guys soon. And thanks for the follow from Smash Ghibli, and thanks for the modding from Blacksmith Forge as ever. Mod of the year. See you guys later.